Okay, guys, welcome. My name and host today is Rodin Apporti. I'm the head of growth of LEAP. And today I'm going to have an interview with one of the best business schools of Barcelona, Madrid, and they recently and brand new campus in Malta. I see already that my co-host joined. Hello.
Hello.
Veronica, Victoria. How are you doing today?
Oh, fine. Thank you. Hope you're doing well.
I'm doing well. I'm currently calling from the headquarters in Barcelona, where it's currently pretty sunny. And I'm happy to say that in Spain, currently the restrictions around Corona are getting better. I don't know if the viewers see it, but I already got a little tan. And that is due to the fact that I'm already had the possibility to go to Tenerife. So I want to give to everybody a little bit of positivity in these dark times that slowly, even in Spain, the restrictions getting better. So the restrictions getting better also means that the universities have more possibilities to host and eventually that we will go back to a new normal. Okay, small introduction from my side. I'm Rodin. I am the head of growth of LEAP, and I will be your the host today. And I'm going to interview Victoria. Victoria is the regional manager of GBSD Global, one of the top business schools, which are located in Barcelona, Malta, and in Madrid. Victoria, welcome. Today, what are we going to talk about? So you're going to introduce your renowned institution, and can you elaborate on the other topics we're going to highlight?
Yes, sure. So first of all, thank you for this introduction. And as you have already mentioned, our school, the business school with four campuses, actually, we have two campuses in Spain, in Barcelona and in Madrid. We have the brand new campus in Malta, and also we have the online campus for 100% distance learning. And what's also important about us, we are the private, fully accredited institution that runs bachelor, master's and MBA programs 100% in English language for international students. So we'll found it especially for international students. And as for the school, we're quite young. We were established in 2011, but still since this time, we achieved quite a lot, and I will definitely tell you about this.
Okay, great. I see already that quite a lot of people joined our weekly session. Guys, please feel free to ask any questions during this webinar. I know for a fact that Victoria can elaborate in a lot of directions, but I think the best way, of course, is if you just ask a question and then the specialist will answer. Okay, thank you very much. I would introduce LEAP, for if you don't mind, pretty briefly. So we are in we are the number one educational agent in Barcelona, Spain. What makes us unique is that we reverse the business model. I think that a lot of viewers know educational agents, but normally the educational agents are located in the country where you currently are. We looked at that business model and thought, like, that's a bit strange though, because you get advised by people who never been to, let's say, Spain. So therefore we thought, where does the student need the help most? And that is, of course, in the country where they're eventually going to study. So we set up a company which is an end-to-end service platform which helps the student from begin to end. And therefore, I have this interview with you today, Victoria. And we help, of course, with preparing in the best way possible to get admitted to a renowned institution like GBSD Global. Furthermore, we help with all visa requirements, accommodations, residence permits, and everything in between what a student needs to focus on the most important things. And that is, of course, making new friends, making new experiences, and in the end, obtaining a great degree. So going to from one side to another, talking about a great degree, could you elaborate a little bit about what type of degrees GBSD Global is offering at the moment?
So I have already mentioned a bit that we offer several programs like bachelor programs, master programs, and MBA programs. Being the private business school means that we provide a teacher appropriate degree. The business school degree is absolutely the same as the university one, so all the students will get the proper degree that allows them to work in their home countries or in Spain. But still, teacher appropriate means that by ourselves, we establish the programs and our tutors, our professors establish the programs we have.
Okay, okay. And if we look at the offering we have at the moment, because I know it, and I find your offering pretty unique in that sense, because what I like so much about it is like a lot of universities, they have a basic offering, and they sometimes forget to look at the time or the needs of the market. And I think you can elaborate a little bit about that, but all the bachelor's and master's you offer are really in line with what companies desire. Am I correct?
Yeah, definitely, definitely. We try to be a really modern school, and we try to pay much attention on digital technologies and digital innovation in general. So, right, all the programs we have, starting from digital marketing in general to sports management or fashion luxury business management, is related to digital innovations and to digital technologies. So we try to implement such courses like SMM sales strategy, working in Google AdWords or Facebook AdWords in all our programs. Because you know that nowadays, especially due to the COVID times, it became more and more popular among all the students worldwide.
Okay, okay, great. And if we're talking about digital innovation, your school is quite special in particular, because you are one of the few schools in Europe, and I think the first one in Spain, who is offering a Microsoft learning method. Am I correct?
Yes, definitely. You're correct. We are the only business school in Spain that has Microsoft Showcase School accreditation. So we are accredited by Microsoft. And also, additionally, all of the students in Barcelona, they have an option to study on Microsoft platforms such tools like Excel, Word, and PowerPoint. It is free of charge for all the students, and they can achieve additional certificates.
Okay, great. And I think a lot of students are interested in times like this, Corona times, where sometimes you only have the opportunity to do it online. I think the Microsoft learning environment gives a unique touch to this experience.
Absolutely.
So, okay. And so in Corona times, it's not always possible to go to the campus. So do you also offer blended learning in that sense?
Yes, actually the blended learning method was really popular even several years ago with us. So we are that school that had all the programs starting from bachelor to master's in online for about a couple of years ago. So we haven't established the campus, the online campus due to the COVID. It had been established before, and we offer the blended learning options for all the students. For example, if we have a bachelor student who would like to start with us the first year online and after that continue on campus in Barcelona, it is possible. In case we have the student who would like to start the first term or the first two terms online, it is also possible for this student. And due to Corona, it became more and more popular. And what's also important about this program, that all the students who are less than 18 years old, all the underage students, they also have an option to join our school, being 17 or even 16 year olds. Okay. They can start online, and after that, once they turn 18, they can come on campus to us. So in this case, they can avoid this procedure of making the guardianship and all these guardians.
Wow, that's great. That's great to hear. Then we can also maybe elaborate a little bit about what is now a business school in general, because we get a lot of questions about the public university sector, and then you have the private university sector. And so what is a business school in general? What does it stand for?
So you're absolutely right that this question is one of the most popular among all the parents and all the students, because when these parents hear the name of the school, they think that it's a general education, the secondary school, but no, it's not. And the main difference between the university and the business school is that the university usually has a big campus with different faculties, with different type of programs like STEM programs, art programs, and the business school is much smaller. We actually have the one program, one specific program related to business, and we have, of course, several majors in this program. And what's also important about business school, that all our programs are related to practice. So we try to be focused on practice, first of all, and comparing to the university where the theoretic skills, academic skills are much more popular. At business school, it's vice versa. And what's also important about us is that we have the small classes for about 20 students in the class maximum. Again, comparing to the university, when we can see the big, the huge classes for about 50, maybe 70 students. So it's not like this in the business course, where kind of tailor-made education for students. So these are the main differences. And of course, one more difference is the tutors. So all our professors, they actually have experience in the same sphere. So they work in the same sphere, they teach. And literally, they provide their experience to all our students.
Okay, great. Now, I'm an experienced expert in that sense, because I also studied at a business school, and I also studied at a university, because I did my bachelor's at a Dutch university, and in the end, I did my MBA here in Spain. And I must say, what I like, for me personally, it was really appealing, because a lot of theoretical knowledge you get in your bachelor's are just coming out of books. And a lot of books are, first of all, most of the time outdated, because especially in times like this, there's so much innovation going on. So if you have a book from 2 years old, a new platform could arise, or a new type of market traction, and that innovation, the theory is simply not applicable anymore. But another thing what I like a lot from business schools, and that is in your institution the same, is that it's pretty practical in terms of a professor comes to the class and he is from most of the time from the market itself. So he is self-taught. Of course, he has a accreditation and everything, but he or worked in the industry and he learned from develop his own theories and experiences, and therefore the business is more practical, and you can make it more your own because of great examples. And that's what I like personally, that I got inspired to also eventually set up this business, due to all the inspiring figures you meet during a business school adventure.
And moreover, the teaching method differs. So when we're talking about teaching in business school, there are not only workshops in the class, there are also group projects, case studies, business game simulations, and what's also important, there are the career visits and industrial visits to different companies. So all our students, about 2-3 times per term, go to different companies depending on the major. For example, if we're talking about sports management, it can be the Football Club Barcelona. If we're talking about PR communication, there are advertising agencies or TV channels. In terms of tourism, of course, there are other hotels and restaurants. And during this visit, for sure, students have workshops made by professionals, and also they have this experience and opportunity to take the internship additionally.
Yeah, that is some really important thing you mentioned now, is of course the whole network. When you join your organization, the alumni network, first of all, is alumni, so all the students who already study it at GBSB. I'm also still in great contact with all my classmates. And furthermore, you have great connections with companies, right? So when you finish your studies, can you elaborate a little bit, like what kind of internship opportunities students have?
Yeah, definitely. So first of all, it's important to say that during the studies, it is not compulsory for students to take the internship. But still, as you know, and I believe that many students know, that it's possible to have internships in Spain. And from outside, we arrange the internship support. So we have the career department that helps our students in finding different types of jobs. And we also give students an access to our internal portal where they may find different types of jobs, starting from internship to part-time job, full-time job. and not only in Spain, but worldwide. And this is important during studies to make such programs. So I know that your agency also provides such options, such services. So I'm pretty sure you can add more about these options in finding employment.
Yes, definitely. Like, I guess quite a lot of students which are now tuning in are from outside of Europe, and joining an institution as GBSP Global or any other institution in Spain is a great opportunity to join eventually the labor force of Europe and become a young professional here. And we offer a variety of great tech sales internships in companies, mainly in Barcelona. And depending on your field of interest and your request, every month, every year, we close more new partnerships with upcoming startups, depending on what kind of profile you have and what kind of experience you want. But especially in Barcelona, since we are based in Barcelona, we have, especially in internships, most connections there. There are a lot of startups, maybe Barcelona stands in the top three in Europe in most startups. And they have a barrio and a neighborhood, which is called Barrio 22. And there's a lot of innovations happening as we speak. And all those companies are searching for young talent like yourself to join, and we have great connections over there. But Victoria, could you elaborate? Could you name some companies where students potentially could work afterwards when they finish their degree?
Yes, sure. So actually, we're really proud to name these companies because they're really huge. So for example, we have quite strong programs in finance, in digital finance, and we have some students who work in such companies like Deloitte, KPMG, Ernst & Young. We have students who continue working in Swarovski office, in Nike, in marketing of Nike. We also have students who work in FIFA and UEFA, and additionally, they are the football agents and the sports agents. We also have quite a lot of students from Amazon who work in Amazon, who continue working in Booking.com, in LinkedIn, so many of them.
Wow, that are big names. Okay, hey, one question from Rashid Reis to keep the audience a little bit engaged. So he's an 18-year-old student, and he was wondering, like, how do you register for your university? How does the process work?
The process is quite simple for all the students, both for bachelor's and for master's. So first of all, as the studies are 100% in English, we will need to check the level of English language. It should be upper intermediate at least, so B2. And we accept international certificates such as IELTS or TOEFL. As for IELTS, it should be 6.0. As for TOEFL, 79 or 80. It is also possible to pass our internal test in case, for example, student doesn't have any international certificate. What's also important, of course, to have a look on the current transcript and a degree of the student, to have a look on GPA. And we will also need to check the motivation letter of the student. It should be kind of essay why he or she would like to apply on our program, to come to Spain, and what are his plans for the future career once he graduates. Of course, we will need to check the recommendation letter from the workplace or from the school in case it's a current student, high school student. And we will need to check the CV. So for master programs, it is not compulsory to have the work experience, but still in this CV, there should be stated some kind of portfolio with all the achievements, like social achievements, sports achievements, maybe volunteering. For business schools, it is always important to know and to see that the student is quite active and highly motivated, because as you may probably know, and some students know that at business schools, the students will need to spend much time on their self-studies as well. So they need to be motivated. And of course, we will need to check the passport and passport size photo. That's it about the documents.
Okay. Guys, don't worry. It's more easy than it sounds. And if there are any problems, Leap Global is here to help you out. with guiding you through the process. And then in the end, there's a quite high acceptance rate. Of course, you need to have the right background and the right motivation. Okay, great. That's really good to hear. As I said already, a lot of people are joining from outside of the EU. And so therefore, I would like to know, if the students go back to their country, let's take an example of one of the students here who comes from Morocco, and they get your renowned degree. What kind of accreditation do they then get? And will what can they do with their degree in their own country? Let's say Morocco as an example.
Mm-hmm. So as I have already mentioned, our school is an international accredited school. So we have the American accreditation, ACBC. We have the British one, like ASIC, and we are actually the only business school in Spain with this accreditation. We have the accreditation of European Commission for Business Education, so it's quite a lot. And with this international accreditation, all the students, wherever they go, they can easily find a job. So we are internationally accredited school.
Okay, that's great. Okay, a little bit of brainstorming from my side. Like, we have now, Victoria, we talked a lot about your university, and we're going to go further soon. But I thought, like, to keep it a little bit engaged, let's talk a little bit about Spain itself, because I think a lot of people which are listening right now, they are also, evaluating other countries, let's say the rainy England or the flat Holland or, I don't know, Russia could be, or other parts of the world. And I would like to elaborate a little bit about why it's so great to study in Spain. Now, me personally, I studied in Spain, and I did it for a few factors. One is that the universities in Spain are just really good. They, as Victoria also said, like they are one of the best of Europe, especially in accreditation. But another element which is quite interesting is the universities are good, really good, but the tuition fees are also good in comparison to English-speaking countries like, let's say, England, America, where the tuition fees sometimes come out for the 30,000 to 40,000 euros per year. And then you obtain the same accreditation in most ways. Another thing about Spain, of course, is I'm from Holland. Holland is considered a flat, rainy country. And the reason I like it so much is because the climate is simply great. I live in Barcelona. It's at the beach. People mostly live outside. And the neighborhoods are really diverse. And people are friendly, really friendly. And cities in Spain, most of all, are also quite international. So when you come, doesn't matter what your background is or what beliefs you have, people know how to deal with international students and people in general. It's a great mixture in Madrid and in Barcelona and in Valencia of cultures. So you don't feel like, wow, what am I doing here? People looking around. No, it's a great blend in that sense. Another thing what I like about Spain is that when you come to Spain and when you finish your education, depends if you're an undergrad student. Of course, when you're an undergrad student, there's still a possibility to do your master's. Victoria, you also, we spoke quite a lot about bachelor so far. Can you elaborate a little bit about which master's your institution offers?
Yeah, definitely. We offer several types of master's. First of all, we have the Master of Arts. The programs that are mostly related to arts in general, like tourism and hospitality management, like fashion, luxury, business management. This program, by the way, is one of the most popular among our girls. And we have the Master of Arts in Communications, Future Marketing, so mostly related to PR and HR for those students. The Business Innovation program. We also have several programs with Master of Science, such as financial programs, Master of Science in Finance, and in Digital Finance. We have the program in Entrepreneurship, Operations and Supply Chain Management.
And digital entrepreneurship, right? Digital entrepreneurship. Mainly focusing on digital and building internet businesses and stuff like that, right?
Definitely. All the programs are related to digital. And as for our operations and supply chain management program, it is rather important to add that we have the partner, the Zaragoza Logistics Center. So this center is a part of MIT Global Scale Network. So this means that our students have an opportunity in 1 week to come to Zaragoza, and they have workshops provided by tutors from MIT, from Massachusetts Institute of Technology. So it's also quite good for them, and it will be really useful for their CV and for the future career as well.
Okay, great. Okay, that's interesting to hear. And yeah, sorry, continue.
Yeah, continuing with the programs, with Master Science programs. We also have, of course, the Master Science in Digital Marketing and E-Commerce program, and in Digital Business for sure. And we have a quite interesting program in Sports Management, and another program, quite new program, in Digital Education. So this program is only online for online studies. We actually tell students about how to launch their online school or online training, online classes, how to establish their, I don't know, Instagram net or other channels via the internet. Quite interesting for all the students.
Wow, that's great. That's great. I know now, as myself, as an entrepreneur, understanding digital landscapes, especially because they are so insanely rapid changing and innovating. And if you have the basis, and especially when it's taught according to a certain mathematic, because there's now a big discussion going on. The big Elon Musk states that you don't need any university schooling anymore. I'm personally a big fan of university schooling, not because I sell it, but I mean that a university gives you, provides you a certain structure. And the university determines when you're ready to go to the next step, and that you don't start at the top, then a little bit here, and you will have a complete theoretical knowledge to prepare yourself for the next step in your career. Or in this case, like there's with the masters, which prepare you for entrepreneurship. I did my master in entrepreneurship, and I must say every day, it doesn't matter what I do, I fall back on the knowledge I obtained. And it's just a really great set of skills you have in the back pockets to fall back on. Okay, so another thing is like, so when you finish your master's, then you can enter the European job market. And I think a lot of the listeners are interested, how does that work? Now, first you can obtain, of course, your student visa, and afterwards it's the possibility that you can start working or doing an internship. And when the company likes your talents, and I think when you're finished with the GPSB Global and you obtain a master or a bachelor degrees, you are shaped in a certain direction that companies like your talents and skills, then the company can file for a working visa. And that can be a working visa up to 5 years. And depending on what happens, of course, it could be an opportunity that you can stay here to pareja the ed show. And that is when you find a companion, could be a relationship or maybe a good friend, let's say, and then you can start your new life in Spain. Okay, Victoria, so we talked a little bit about the masters, but mainly you offer bachelors. Is that correct, or what is the ratio of the amount of...
We have more master programs, but okay. usually the last couple of years, bachelor programs are more popular among the students, especially among young students who would like to move to Spain and to start their career in digital or in entrepreneurship. So we have 7 majors in bachelor. All the majors are related to business administration and digital innovation, but still we have just 7 of them, like digital entrepreneurship, digital PR, communication, finance and fintech, sports management and esports, digital marketing, fashion luxury business management, and of course, general management.
Okay, great. And
the duration of this program is 3 years. And by the way, speaking of masters, it is 1 year only. And for all the programs, we offer free intakes. So our students can start in October, in January, and in April. They can choose any date they like. Wow. And we don't have fixed deadlines. But of course, it depends on the number of students in the group. And so for those students who need visa, We recommend to apply no later than 3, maybe 4 months prior the intake start date to make sure they will be ready with their visa.
That's a really good point you mentioned, Victoria. We live in exciting and also a bit challenging times, though. Exciting is maybe not really the right word for it, but on the other hand, like, it keeps the humanity sharp and innovating. However, it also means that certain processes, bureaucratic processes like obtaining your visa, are simply a bit more difficult. So therefore, all the listeners who are now tuning in, I would highly advise to contact LEAP as soon as possible so we can look at your situation and start applying for your visa or start with the admission as soon as possible. So we will have no time constraints in that sense. And as of now, we are really proud to say that we have a 95% visa acceptance rate. So if you have any doubts, even if you are from a difficult part in terms of visa, let's say India or Iraq, last week we processed proudly to say 3 visas from Iraq without any problems. So if you have any doubts in that direction, just contact us and we will tell you how high your chances are. But so far, if you structure it in a proper way and you combine them with a little bit of experience from our side, there's a big chance that almost everyone who is now tuning in can obtain a European visa.
And okay, yes, from my point of view, yeah. I would also like to emphasize that for all the students, it is better to apply for the visa via the agencies or via LEAP, because in case the direct student tries to apply directly and gets visa refusal, it's rather hard for this student to get Spain. So it is better from the early beginning to start working with a professional.
Thank you very much. Yeah, but therefore we are here around because you are specialized in providing top-notch education. And we are here simply to facilitate to come there without any stress or obstacles. Because we heard sometimes some sad stories about people, and I think you know that as well from your institution, quite a lot of people apply and then they simply don't know how to start and where to start. So in that case, just contact one of our consultants. We offer free personal consultations where we look at your personal case, your personal preferences, and then we will search for the best solution which fits your needs and budget in that sense. Okay, let's go a little bit further in GBSB in general. Great job about that you guys opened another campus in these challenging times. So as of now, you have a beautiful campus in Barcelona and you have a campus in Madrid, the capital. And you opened another campus. Can you elaborate on that?
Yeah, for sure. We're really proud of this, in fact. And so we have the brand new campus in Malta, in Birkirkara city. So for now, we will offer the same bachelor programs as in Barcelona, so 7 majors again, in all the programs in Bachelor of Business Administration and Digital Innovation. In Malta, the campus works according to the Bologna system as well as in Spain, and the duration of these programs are also 3 years. What's also important about this campus, first of all, speaking of the country in general, Malta is not that popular with the higher education. It's much more popular with the summer schools, but still not everybody knows that for now Malta is one of the hugest and rapidly growing economies in the US. In the EU, sorry. And also, it's really famous for its conferences in artificial intelligence, in blockchain, in gaming. So there are really much things to do and to work on. So for the students who will graduate our programs in Malta, they will have quite a lot of career opportunities because it's, the economics is still growing, and from day to day there are appearing new companies, new startups. So for all the students who are interested again in entrepreneurship, it can be also really useful. And we have in our campus on Malta also accreditation of National Commission of Higher and Further Education. So this
Great
means
job.
That Yeah, thank you. And all the students, they will get the diploma accredited by the Ministry of Education of Malta.
So yeah, that is, guys, for the people who are listening here, that is really impressive, because Spain is not giving away easily this kind of accreditations. An institution needs to have a high standard in terms of teaching method, in terms of facilities, and also just in terms of the experience of teaching. And you went, I guess, through a pretty heavy control or a validation commission to obtain this accreditation. And it means with this accreditation, you have a national accredited degree, similar to some of the public universities. Is that correct?
Yes, that's absolutely correct. And this degree is some kind related to the British degree, for example, the British state degree. So we offer the level 4, level 5, and level 6 in Malta, the bachelor of this level, like the British degree.
Okay, okay. So the name GBSB Global, it's also in terms of all the accreditations and the global standards, you are standing out of the crowd. So really, really cool to hear. Some questions from the people. Guys, everybody who's listening right now, please ask your questions right now. The education experts are currently here to assist you in the best way possible. There's a question about admission again. Is the admission for bachelor students and master students the same?
Yes, it's absolutely the same. We have the same requirement for English level. And of course, the only difference is that the bachelor students, they will need to provide their high school diploma together with transcripts. And of course, master students, they will need to provide their university diploma. And what's also important about the admission process, that in case the student is the current student and still doesn't have his final degree, that's fine. We can proceed with a provisional transcript and with the letter from the university or from his high school confirming that this only is next year, he will graduate. So by the moment of studying with us, the student will be the graduate student.
Okay. Okay, great. Okay, guys, we are almost in the end of this Instagram Live. Before we close or we end today, I would like to give a small a motivation to everybody who is listening at the moment, because there were a lot of challenges the last years, and I truly believe as an expert, if I analyze the global markets, especially in terms of education, that the coming months, borders will open, schools at GBSB will operate on normal strengths again and can use all their facilities. And the fear in the people, even under the weakest of society, who will receive hopefully soon all and vaccination, will vanish and we will go back to normal. What I want to say is, guys, don't hesitate and wait too long. And it's simply a waste of your beautiful life in that sense if you now postpone, and you miss your study gap and your opportunities. Work, believe me, I'm working now 7 years, and at a certain moment you realize studying is simply one of the greatest periods of your life, and if you postpone it too long, you simply miss out on it. So contact me or one of my team and just brainstorm about your opportunities. See what is possible, but please, guys, please don't miss out, because there's still fear of all what happened. But most of the time, out of fear comes great opportunity and even stronger people. So let's see it as an opportunity. With this said, I would like to thank you a lot for your time, Victoria. And I am looking forward to our next Instagram Live. For now, guys, if you have any questions, you can reach us on Instagram, on through our website, studiesinspain.com, or you can send us an email, or you can call us right away, where we can plan a personal consultation with one of our renowned educational experts, and we're going to make your dream to come to Spain a reality. Okay, Victoria, thank you very much for your time. I wish you a good day, and let's stay in touch and speak soon.
Yeah, thank you. It was a great pleasure to join you today.
Okay, likewise. Speak later. And guys, everybody who joined in, thank you very much for your time and see you in a few weeks with our next university. Okay, bye-bye. See you.